It's your boy Jimmy Blue, Mr. All Access Elite Boxing, reporting live from Arlington, Texas, here at Texas Live. I'm with one of the best trainers in the world, Coach Joel Diaz. How you doing, Coach?
Thank you. I appreciate the compliment, man. We're here just another day in the office. We're here to work.
Let me ask you this, Coach Joel. You know, the atmosphere, man, it's weigh-ins. You know, Virgil Ortiz versus Orozco. I know you also have a fighter on the card, Marcelino Lopez, going against
Daniel Echeverria.
Exactly. Yep. Let me ask you, Coach, are you surprised as far as the atmosphere, you know, the amount of people that came out to support here in Texas?
I'm never surprised when I come to Texas, because Texas is it's a great place for boxing. Texas has by far one of the biggest fans of the sport of boxing. I've been here in Dallas a few times, and it's always great. The atmosphere is great. The hospitality is great. And the people, you know, because here in Dallas, people love boxing.
Let me ask you this, Coach Joel Diaz. I know that, you know, speaking on Virgil Ortiz, a hometown kid, he's here fighting in the main event in his first time in his hometown in Grand Prairie, Texas. I know he started as a pro with you. You know, he ended up going to RGBA. What makes Virgil such a tremendous and a special fighter?
The character in himself. Virgil Ortiz, when he came to my camp, he was still an amateur. Two summers, I think, if I'm not wrong, he came. And in the last summer he was with us, he won the national tournament that we had in the Valley, which was a national invitation. From there on, you know, I saw the ability on this kid, and I said, this kid's going to be big. Because as a trainer, I've been training fighters for over 25 years. And it's rare when you run into a fighter like Virgil Ortiz that has everything a fighter needs to become one of the best fighters in the world. He's one of those fighters that loves to work. He loves the sport. He has the heart, determination, and most of all, he's hungry. He's a hungry kid. He's 100% disciplined, you know. And more than that, he's 100% clean. He's a kid that doesn't drink, don't smoke. He don't like partying. He don't like everything. To him is boxing. He takes boxing really serious, and that's what makes Virgil Ortiz the person he is now, and the big superstar he's gonna be. To me, honestly, I mean, I'm not working with him anymore, but you know, I'm a big fan of his style. I'm a big fan of the personality that he carries. You know, he is a very respectful kid, very quiet kid, but inside him, there's an animal that comes out when he's in the ring. He has power in both hands. He has perfect timing. He's a smart fighter, very good patience, and every punch he lands is a punch that does damage.
Who does he remind you of, Coach? I mean, I know you've been in the sport of boxing for many, many years. Who does he remind you of?
It's been a while since I can tell you I see a fighter like Virgil Ortiz. Virgil Ortiz, to me, reminds me of a young Fernando Vargas. A young Fernando Vargas. That Fernando Vargas who beat up on Campos and Marquez. That's the type of fighter, but with a difference of 100% discipline.
Let me ask you this, Coach. You know, when I spoke to his father a couple of weeks ago, you know, he mentioned that he's so good right now at his age that he's unable to get the fights as far as, you know, with kids his age, because he'll blow them out of the water. He's too good for his own good. Being at such a young age, at 21 years old, 13-0, you know, he's knocked out everybody. How difficult is it going to be, do you feel, as far as being, I mean, we all know that he's a major player in the 147-pound weight division, but all the major names, you know, they're not going to want to take that risk with him. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, it's a process. You know, Virgil Ortiz eventually has to fight all the top fighters in that division. That's why there's rankings. There's ways to get up there. Right now, you know, he's going to move up in the rankings, and sooner or later, it's going to be mandatory that he has to face all these welterweights in the division.
Let me ask you this, Coach. How do you see this fight against Orozco playing out?
It's going to be a tough fight. It's going to be a tough fight in the early rounds. But I think Virgil, with his patience and how smart he is, he's going to start figuring Antonio Orozco out. Maybe 3-4 rounds, 5 rounds. But honestly, Antonio Orozco is a great kid, man. I like him. I like him a lot. As a matter of fact, he had approached me for training. Before this camp, he had contacted me. His manager contacted me to train Antonio Orozco.
Oh, wow.
But, you know, the only difference is, you know, I feel bad that I couldn't train him because he went from his early trainers. He went to Frey Roach. I mean, Manny Robles, and then he went to Frey Roach. And the reason why he switched trainers, was he wanted more time on a one-on-one type of training. And, you know, I distribute my time among my fighters.
That's right.
And I really don't, I don't feel comfortable when somebody tells me, can you give me more one-on-one? Because that's not the way I train, you know. I don't have one fighter. I have a lot of fighters.
That's right.
So I train my fighters individually, as a team, and everybody does well. But him coming with that mentality that he's leaving Frey Roach and he wants more on one-on-one, I couldn't provide him that one-on-one, that more time on one-on-one. And I feel bad about it because he's a great, respectful kid. He always comes to shake my hand. Very, very humble, very humble kid. But, you know, I just think that at this point of his career, Virgil, with his youth, strength, his ability, he is the bigger guy, the stronger, and the more significant fighter of the sport.
Let me ask.